Hello guys, it's really been nice having you around. So today I was supposed to be talking about the queries, but I've been getting a lot of requests to do to explain the tables very well, all the data types and the fields. So sorry, for now I shall be explaining the tables properly so that everyone may be understand before we move on to the next step. So before I continue, I also wanted to add you guys, as you watch, please just remember to subscribe, because according to the analytics, most of you are just watching, gaining everything. It's not bad, but it will be good if you just subscribe. It gives me some motivation, and it's good. It makes me continue releasing videos like this. So straight into it. So today I should be talking about, and I'll be clarifying more about the tables. The accessor, go on to the, here it is. But if time allows, I can make the queries at the end of the video. That would be good. So let's wait for it to load. Enable content. Yeah. So let me just go from the first table till down. I'll be not following in. I'll not be following the order, or let me just follow the order. So according to the question paper, first where to register members. Members can either be registered in groups or an individual. A group member is a person who has a low income of a low produce of its at its firm. While an individual member, these are members that are high produce. They are actually, let's say, large scale farmers. So for individual members, let me just move into the design view for you to see. So I'm going to start with the individual member. So under individual member, I created the member number, that's the first field name. So let me just pass through the field names and the data types. I used the member number. So it's proper to use the member number then, so that you can identify the members. So the data type for the member number is auto number, so that it can automatically generate the numbers. Then from there are some changes we made. There are some fields that we had to add to make it a better system. So for the format, I had to change the format to add. So the I and M represents the individual member. Then the zeros, these are the real member number now. Okay, then when we move on to the member name. So the member name, the next field. So member name, the data type is short text as usual. Under the description, I think nothing is important over there. So move next to the ID number. So ID number, I used short text so that I'll explain that part later. So ID number, the ID data type for ID number, I used short text, which for the reason why I use short text and not number is because when I had to use number, then zero would be omitted. When you start with zero, it will be omitted. So I decided to use a short text. Then I gave it this validation rule: is not null and it's like. So the values are 0 to 9, and they must be eight characters. So 0 to 9, those are 8 times. That is it. From there, I move on to the contact. So So I also use a short text, but the input mask is 10 and it's not null. And yeah, that's the validation rule. Move on to the location. Location, there's nothing fancy over there. Move on next to the next table, which is the group members. So group members are members who have it's a small scale farmers. So if you are a small scale scanner, then you have to register as a group. Form a group of 5 members, then register. So we shall be having the group ID, which are the data type will be auto number. The format is just the same. The changes is just here, GM instead of IM. GM representing group member. So you can input any that you want, but for my case, I think that will represent it better instead of writing some fancy letters over there. So next is the group name. This to be then the name of the group. So the data type for the group name is a short text. Next, the member name. So here, member name is comprise all the details of the members, ID numbers, same as the one for the individual member. So here, from member name downwards, they're just the same. So from member name, ID number, the same validation rule and text. Data type is short text. For the context, also short text. Location, also short text. So we are done with the group members. We move on to the next. So after group members, after members have registered the system. Now the next bit was about transportation, which you cannot transport anything without the means of transport. So we shall move on to the vehicles. So the vehicles. Now to register the vehicles, shall be having the vehicle ID. So the vehicle ID via to number. Again, the same thing applies down here for the format. This time I'm using V to represent vehicles. Then we shall input the vehicle registration number. After that, the year of make. Then the color of the vehicle. Then the vehicle category. I've input number here because let me just explain as we move on. Because I'm going to introduce the second table, which is the vehicle category, because it will be under the relationship. We shall define vehicle category, whereby you don't need to type in the category. So you shall be selecting the category from the vehicles category over here. So here is one which has the short text. The vehicles categories, whether it's a lorry, a pickup, that one. So from there, so we are also already done with the two vehicles. After using the vehicles, you have to register now the cater for the employees. So the employees are 2 employees, either you're a driver or a loader. So let me explain about that one. We have the employee number. Data type is auto number. The same applies for the format. So if you are keen enough, this one is just you can see a repetition of this one all through the system. From there you have the employee name, the contact, the gender, the age, and here the designation actually implies for the area or specification of work, which is a driver loader. So in that area, I'm using a number here instead of short text for the same reason as before under vehicles and category here. So we are going to be using number because we are going to be selecting the employee category from another table instead of typing the category each time there. After registration of members, then we move on to the transporting. So under the transport, we can move on to the transport order. For your transport, you shall put an order for the transport to the company. So we shall record the order number. Again, the same thing applies over here. I've used T to represent the transport, the order date, the product transported, I'm using number because we'll be generating the product to be transported from here, the product transported from another table. Instead of typing them, here it is, here is where we shall be naming it bit by bit. So from there I move on to, so from the transport order, then finalize the final field is the order category. Order category simply, these are implies for are you ordering as a group or as an individual. So under order category, you shall be having under here category, are you a group or an individual over here. Next is the services offered for the vehicles. So you should be taking services for the vehicles. So we shall be having the service number, which is auto number, the vehicle to be serviced. So here you shall be getting these the vehicles from the vehicles table. That's why I'm using number. So you shall be getting the vehicles from the vehicles table. Again, service done, which I'll be getting it from the services offered over here. There's another table here, the service done and the service number. Then from there, date of service and the cost of servicing. That's all about service. From there, I move on to the offenses. So offenses, these are the one committed, overloading, yeah, something like that. So we shall have the offense registration number. So the driver responsible for the offense shall be picking it from the employer, from the employee details, where we shall be specifying in the queries which I'm going to be generating. From the queries we shall be generating from the queries specifically for the drivers, not for the loaders, because drivers are the one committing the offense over speeding and all that. So the criteria over there shall be showing when you reach the part of to the part of queries. From there I move on to the vehicle involved. Again, we shall be getting the vehicle involved from the vehicles table. That one will be done by relationship. I'm putting here number to help in the relationship part. From there you move on to the offenses committed. So offenses committed again is another table here where we have the offenses registered here. So in case of there's another offense to be added, we just add it to the offense committed table. Then we can easily select it instead of typing it each time. Action taken, again you have got the table for the actions. Either you give him a letter or is being sacked, or yeah, those are the actions to be taken. After action taken, the amount charged for that offense, it could be 2,000, 5,000, any amount. So those are the tables that will be required for the system to work. I think I've explained well. In case of any other queries, please you can feel free to contact me. I shall put the contact down there be at the right hand side of the video. So in case you need to contact me, just to do that. And also there's so from this one, the next one is queries. You shall be creating the queries. So I shall be explaining how the following queries should be created from everything from scratch. And then yeah, I think that would be better. But before queries, there's someone else who actually asked for the relationship, right, for me to explain about the relationship. So I think that will be something like 3 to 5 minutes, then we'll be done. Okay. So just don't forget to subscribe and like to keep the channel ongoing. The main thing is just hit subscribe and share if possible. That's okay. I think that will be all for today's video. So keep tuned for the next one, which is relationships. So I shall be explaining the relationships keenly so that everyone can understand. Then the tables. I'll be putting it in the description box for you to, you can download it and use it. You can use it from any part. So thank you. See you next time.